So I'm Andrew Shobin, and this is Shah Shobin, and we're the founders of the Tail Company. And we've been making animatronic tails now for, well, since 2006. As an artist making work in public spaces, we found that wearing a tail was a wonderful way of initiating a kind of creative and fun moment. You know, you're being very serious in the bank, but your tail is knocking off the pencils. And so we started wearing them, and we started getting people saying, oh, I'd really like one of those. Let's have one of those. So we set the tail company up, and about 6 years later, we've made our 500th tail, and we launched a Kickstarter. And since then, we set up the business, and we produce tails full time. And they're sold all over the world. We just sold our first tail in Indonesia. We would happily send a tail to North Korea. Yeah.
Japan, obviously. America's our biggest market, I think.
Yeah. All of the parts are produced on Prusa printers. I mean, if you want me to talk about printers, I am happy to talk about printers because it's literally 90% of my day. We've tried every kind of printer. I'm not saying this because you guys are Prusa, but really honestly, we've tried every kind of printer. We have three MK3s. We've got a Cubicon out the back, which takes 3 men to carry and starts up in about an hour if it's feeling like it. And then we discovered the Prusas and obviously the Prusa clones, which are everywhere. And we standardizing on one printer was absolutely the way to go. The turnaround time is fantastic on a because you can pull the bed off, pop the part off, and it can be printing again in 30 seconds. We literally run them 24/7 because without them, there are no tails. So we started off by making a tail or two every day. Mm. Now we're making, I mean, the exact numbers are vary from month to month, but it increases from the bottom of the year through to December, but we're making hundreds and hundreds of tails at the moment, and always producing new kinds of tail. So we're also launching our new ears, our ear gear.
Yeah.
And they're really popular. I mean, especially this time of year for Halloween, these are cosplayers, performers. Someone off the stage will control the tails whilst they're dancing or whatever. So what I would say is, if you look at the 100% of the market, I would say you've got 10 or 15%, which is people who want to go to a party. They're having a party and the girls want to go as bunny rabbits or there's a festival. So these kind of guys, probably 10, 15%. Then you've got cosplay, like you say, and that's everything from X-Men through to anime and manga, which I've never heard of, really specialist stuff. And they'll send us as much documentation of that as we can and we'll build a custom tail for them. They're the guys who say, hello, I'm a 6'4" blue Alsatian. Can you make me a tail? And we make them a tail, and they're fantastic to deal with. They know what they want, and they want only the best furs, the softest stuff.
It's our longest haired fur. It's really long haired, which is really lovely.
And people are very particular about what they want.
Yeah.
These have actually got spare pins on there, so we can put in body sensors, pulse, ECG, heart rate. The future would be us wearing a fitness band, for example, that counts what your heartbeat is, for example, but link that to the tail. So you don't have to control anything at all. You're feeling excitable, so is your tail, nice and frisky. You know, you're a bit sleepy, your tail wants to go to sleep. I think the future is, for us certainly, is being able to link into lots of other body sensors and body parts. This is we call it the D-clip. One of the things about people who wear tails is that they can't sit down. So with this, you can quickly remove the tail, sit down, go to the toilet, whatever it is you need to do, and then clip, it's back on again.